It's a sunny Tuesday morning right here in the nation's capital, Abuja. How was your night? I'm Gloria Oji Imodi.
And it's over 26 degrees Celsius here in the nation's capital, Abuja. Thank you for joining us on the show. Welcome. I am Itogi Moore, Edit.
You know, just insert a very motivational morning speech. And yeah, I'm actually doing it.
Indeed.
Okay, now talking about motivation, the Nigerian police is doing its best to motivate Nigerians and to kind of breach
motivate
the gap
Nigerians?
In terms of,
I love your choice of words.
Motivate Nigerians.
May I finish, please?
Drop it the way it is, Gloria.
May I finish, please? I'm starting on a very good note. Now, the Nigerian police really is trying to motivate Nigerians to have a better relationship with the Nigerian police force, and they have come out with guidelines on how to get arrested or how to conduct yourself during an arrest. The first thing they say is, do not resist arrest, even if you perceive the arrest to be illegal. Now, what happens is that an arrest can easily degenerate into an encounter that could be harmful, that can cause injuries, and possible death or disability. So you need to conduct yourself appropriately. Now, you have every right to ask the name of the arresting officer, why you're being arrested, where you're being taken to. You also have the right, especially when you get to the police station, to ask that you make a call to a family member or a lawyer, because we know situations where people get arrested,
Gloria,
and everybody's looking for them and it's like poof,
Gloria,
they have disappeared. So the Nigerian police force is trying to let you know, please don't get hurt. They are admitting that they are bad eggs. They are admitting that they have problems with their procedure
beyond,
of engagement,
it goes
but
beyond
they're trying
that
to
admitting
save lives.
That they are bad eggs and they don't follow procedures. Gloria, in Nigeria here, once you're arrested by the Nigerian police force, it's a very big deal, because one, you have to just do a whole lot. No lawyer, no access to people outside, just because they want to extract some information
I think that information was just too apprehensive
by the Nigerian police.
The part of this information that it was quite unique and got to me was the part where they said, you know, before you subject yourself to a search, you have a right to search the police officer. I was like,
you know, okay. You try.
So I imagined myself saying, officer, please, could you just raise your hands up?
Like,
I need to. The officer's going to ask, I mean, what is going on here? But you know what? Let's put this in context. Whether you are right or wrong, whether the police officer is right or wrong, people get killed. I mean, a lot of incidences where people got killed because either the police officer got a little bit trigger happy, or the citizen, or the person who
happy.
Was,
yeah.
or the
they're
person,
happy,
or the
Gloria.
Person who got, who is getting arrested gets a little bit.
And
too
I think the words they used for that, Gloria,
the
is
day,
the fact that
dies.
They said you would never know the mental and mindset of the police officer as at the time of the arrest. So that
exactly.
is what they're trying
so
to
So it's
find.
Important
Which
for you
means
to
it
protect
could be in
yourself.
Or someone, a happy policeman.
Imo, calm down. Imo,
I understand, but can you also understand that that's a very dangerous job? They get killed a lot, they get hurt.
Yeah,
too. So let's think for them. I want to save my life, and I'm sure you want to save yours. So just do these things first. When we do it and nothing happens, then we can come back and raise flags
see,
and say,
to definitely, you know, put more points for Gloria. The IGP has told us that SARS contributes to 80% of the successes that the Nigerian police has recorded. So yeah, Gloria is right. Follow like the Nigerian police. Don't be like Imo. Be
okay.
Like
Don't be like me, but let me tell you that there's a whole lot of pressure on the National Assembly to reject the reappointment of the Central Bank of Nigeria Governor Godwin Emefiele. Yesterday, just last week, we heard the whistleblower George Ubah releasing lots of allegations against the governor who has been reappointed for another 5 years. So the pressure now is on the National Assembly. The House of Rep, they have started the procedure to, screen him again and confirm his reappointment. But for the Senate, we wait to see what happens.
Well,
they accept the pressure.
Well, the truth of the matter is,
enter again.
The truth of the matter is that he is not, you know, it's not that he is being reappointed. The president has tipped, has nominated that he be reappointed a second tenure. So all of the confirmation will happen if the Senate does agree. But you see, it is pretty interesting, the timing of all of these things, because Emefiele has been here for a long time.
Yes, George
Ubah is just showing up right now with his accusations. All those audios are coming out right now. Why didn't all
why
these
now?
Things happen?
See,
you know, it is too political
sometimes. You know the beauty about this? It's even if the Senate does not approve, Baba will remain in acting capacity. We've seen that.
Mago has been there for a long time without confirmation.
Yes.
He's been there without confirmation.
The back and forth, like, you know, Gloria says about Ubah's accusation, about the leaked audio, and then show arrest suspension. There's a lot of things
fire
going on fire, social media about
fire
it.
The fire, but yeah. Fire yeah. those who fire you.
We're watching. Now, of course, I'd like to remain on that, but sadly, today marks the 16th birthday celebration of Leah Sheripu. Now, Leah Sheripu is one of the 110 girls that was kidnapped in Dapchi. Now, Leah Sheripu, this is the 449th day in captivity. She's still there. Hundreds of Nigerians in the United Kingdom and the United States are going to the Nigerian Mission House in these places, you know, in a march to basically call for her release and then, you know, commemorate today as is. Down here in Nigeria, in Abuja, in Yola, in Jos, and in Adamawa, there would also be, you know, matches. Stay on Roots TV. I'll definitely be there at the Unity Fountain later today and bring you the live updates. This actually is something that breaks the hands of Nigerians.
It's extremely painful because, you know, really as a parent, yeah. I can't even imagine what the mother is going through. I mean, you haven't seen your child for 449 days, and there really isn't any proof of life. Even though we're trying to be as optimistic as possible, you don't know how your child is faring. You don't know where your child is. It's really devastating. So all of us, we need to get into this. We need to be on social media reminding the government that Leah Sheripu has to get back. Now, to end this, let's try something, a bit of gossip. Interestingly, you know, there has been this, when I say gossip or the speculation, that all isn't well in the APC. Mm. Well, we first saw the whole hullabaloo between Tinubu, Jagaban, and the president when both of them refused to show up at each other's public functions. Now it's like El Rufai, the governor of Kaduna State, is taking a swipe at Tinubu when he said in Lagos, y'all need to learn, you Lagosians, how to get rid of your Jagabans. Well, Tinubu is saying, I use the word Jagaban. Of course, we know the godfathers, but godfatherism is some serious ish in Nigeria.
Now, after the statement by El Rufai, you know, and then Tinubu replied to him, El Rufai came out to say, whoever feels offended by what I said can do his worst.
Exactly. And he's got guts.
Oh my God.
He's got strong guts.
Anyways, we're not fighting here. There's all love around this area. Now, breakfast is being served. And right now, I am in the mood for something really simple. For everyone, I've done toast. I've done all of... Hey, can we just try to eat moi moi for breakfast today?
Nah, not moi moi. Akara, maybe.
No, moi moi.
I think I'm fine.
Nah, you want hard breakfast.
I'll skip all of that. I'm fine.
Anyways, you have a beautiful Tuesday. My name is Gloria Oji Emodi.
It's been a wonderful day. And yeah, it's just Tuesday. But hang in there. I might send you a break.
And I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'm Itogi Mo Edit.